Hey, all late but great. This is Jim here from Ohio, and it is Friday, and I am your host on Fridays on the channel Out Late but Great. So anyway, guys, this is like one of the most beautiful days that we've experienced up in Ohio for forever. I mean, it is absolutely phenomenal. Let me show you. Hang on a second. So yeah, we got blue skies. It's about 75 degrees Fahrenheit, that is. Dave planted some tulips in the back garden there. You can see those. It's just perfect. And like flowers are starting to come out everywhere, and look at that sky. Wow. So yeah, we're now, you know, when you're stuck in the house for months, this something like this is really makes you feel so much better. It really does. So anyway, guys, Jim from Atlanta picked the topic of the week, and he wants us to name three activists that have really affected us, or we think a lot about in the gay community. Well, I thought a lot about this. There's just so many. There really are. The first one, and I hope I don't sound too repetitive, because I did talk about this a couple years ago in a video. The first one would have to be Dave Pallone. Now, Dave Pallone was an umpire in the National League back in the 80s. He basically was outed, I think, and he rewrote a book, which I have right here. It's called Behind the Mask. And at the time, he started making his rounds on the talk shows promoting the book. And I remember I saw him on the Phil Donahue show, and you have to remember, at that time, there were no gay characters on TV. There were no, if they did mention that someone was gay, they always showed someone that was flamboyantly effeminate or whatever. And then Dave comes along, and you see a guy who you would never know was gay. He was very masculine, very, very handsome, and he was into sports. And I think the whole stereotype thing, really, people were like, "What? That he can't be gay. He's not weak or whatever." And he was actually fired. He was actually fired back then from being an umpire from the National League, which I'm telling you. Look at the difference now. I mean, I was thinking about Jason Collins, and Jason is the guy that just came out this past week, the basketball player. Instead of being fired, he is being congratulated by presidents and getting calls, and he has so much support, which it just goes to show you how times have changed so much. They really have. Dave has been I've talked to him a couple times on Facebook. Yeah, I became friends with him, and he's not on Facebook that often, but I did tell him how much he meant to me, because at that time, I was so sick of being in the closet. I really was. I had just had it. You know, I was 30 years old. I couldn't take it anymore, and that really is what gave me the push to come out. It really did. So if you're listening, Dave, thanks a lot again. You don't really, you know, how many people you've helped. You really have. So, okay, he's number one. Number two would have to be. Now, I almost kind of made them number one, because they're so special to me. Would be the Leffew family, Jay and Brian, Daniel and Selena. I started watching their videos when Selena was just like in a baby chair. And I mean, look at her now. They've both grown up so much, and they've become, I'm proud to say that they've become good friends of ours. I mean, we've been to their home. We've met them in San Francisco. We've met them in New York. They're just awesome. And the magic of their family is that they're just showing their family as being a normal, healthy, happy family. And that's what it's all about. You know, how can you criticize that? Daniel and Selena are so bright and mature for their age. They really are. So I'm really looking forward to them. They're actually going to come this summer and pay us a visit here in Ohio. So I'm really looking forward to that. So Okay, they're my number two. Love you guys. Number three would have to be Zach Wahls. Now, once again, I met Zach. We met him in San Francisco. And to be honest with you guys, I have never, ever met a more mature young man and brilliant. He really is. I mean, this kid is going to go far. And when I say kid, you have to realize he's only 21 years old, which is, it's almost unbelievable. It really is. You know, how many 21-year-olds do you know that have done what he's done? I mean, his stuff with the Boy Scouts and marriage equality, and every time I turn around on television or on the internet, I see pictures of him shaking hands with presidents and stuff. So his mothers did a hell of a job. They really did. You know, I'm so proud of Zach. I really am. So he's my number three. But you know, guys, there are so many other ones. There really are. Some of the blogs that are out there. I love goodasyou.org. It's written by a guy named Jeremy Hooper, who is married to his partner in New York. And Jeremy is so great at pointing out the hypocrisy with the National Organization of Marriage and all these crazy right-wing kooks. He follows them all and puts all their words out there, and it pisses them off so much. It really does. So if you get a chance to read his blog, you got to. It's so funny. It really is. So really, guys, that's about all I have to say. This weekend we have a big weekend. Dave's sister Kathy is going to get married. Now, she was married before. I think I told you. Her husband passed away back in the 90s. And so her first marriage was a great big Catholic wedding and all that. But tomorrow, she's going to get married in a civil ceremony in one of the Cleveland suburbs. So we're looking forward to that. Dave's going to give a speech, and he's actually going to give her away because their father passed away. So yeah, we're going to rent a limousine and do the thing and then go out to dinner with a few friends. So it should be fun. It really should. So anyway, guys, that's all I got to say. Take care. Love you. And go get out. And if your weather is like this, you better get out and enjoy it, because it's phenomenal. It really is. Take care. Bye-bye.